The revolution will be live.
All right, the president's executive order to end family separations. Again, separations that this White House, this administration chose to implement, facing major headwinds 2 days after it was signed. We still don't know how it will be implemented and what it means for those who still are not with their children. Joining us now is Matt Schlapp, former political director in the George W. Bush White House and the chairman of the American Conservative Union. Matt, great to have you with us. I want to ask you about a little bit of breaking news, a statement just made by the president on Republican efforts to pass an immigration bill in Congress. The president just said Republicans should stop wasting their time on immigration until after we elect more senators and congressmen, women in November. Dems are just playing games, have no intention of doing anything, on and on and on. My question to you, though, is the very first sentence, Republicans should stop wasting their time on immigration. Did he just spike, once and for all, any immigration legislation?
Well, no, John, because the first problem we have is obviously they're trying to do a Republican-only bill, pass it through the House of Representatives. The Goodlatte version got almost 200 votes. Now we have this more moderate version, and they just don't have the votes for it.
Right.
Even just with Republicans, their own Republican bill, they don't have the votes. The problem with what the president is saying is that Congress is going to have to act on one part of immigration, and they're going to have to act before the election, and that's this idea of putting into law that we won't separate families who cross the border illegally. That, as you know, that policy was put in place by a consent decree between the federal judicial branch and President Clinton.
Well,
that is the problem.
The Flores agreement. It was a federal judge who put it.
That's right. They updated it during the end of the Obama administration to make sure that families would be separated, not because they were trying to be cruel, because they felt like kids being placed within a situation where people are incarcerated for adults are being incarcerated for breaking the law, it's bad for the kids. So you can look at what we're trying to do as a country, but you can only change the law through Congress.
You can only change the law through Congress. Again, and you're right about Flores, you're right about the legal decisions, but this current situation was created by a choice from this administration to prosecute people crossing the border, which they knew, which Jeff Sessions told us he knew would lead to family separation. So,
John, you said crisis is not because President Trump was trying to separate families.
No.
The crisis is because of zero tolerance, including people who cross the border with families. And what Jeff Sessions talked about in that piece that you had earlier in your coverage is that thousands of the 12,000 kids we're talking about were kids that were accompanied by people who weren't their parents.
Understood. There's two different things, Matt. Let me just be clear so our audience doesn't get confused here. There's maybe 12,000 minors right now who are being held, 10,000 were unaccompanied, but 2,000 were separated from their parents of a choice. It was a choice that Jeff Sessions told us he knew he was making. He knew it would lead to the separation of children from their parents. We're past that right now. That's just the
fact. I just want to make one point.
Let me keep going, Matt. That was a choice the administration made. They just did. Now the issue is how to get those children back together with their families. And it doesn't seem like there's any plan in place. Can you imagine not knowing where your child is after that child has been taken you from the government and then being told we don't know where they are?
Look, you're right to hold the administration accountable on making sure that if they make a promise that they're going to reunite kids with their parents, it's on them to make sure that happens. We've already gotten news last night that 500 children have been reunited with their parents, but every single one of them, you know, hold them accountable. It's right for you to hold Congress accountable on the fact that they can't have it both ways. If they want to make sure that families don't get separated from a legal standpoint, that no president can ever do that, then they have to change the law. And finally, it's important that we hold both President Trump, Obama, Presidents Bush, Presidents Clinton, the idea that there is a choice, that a president has a choice whether or not to follow the law, I think is quite controversial. The president, President Trump is in a tough position. Our laws say that when you cross the border illegally as an adult, you must be prosecuted. Our law also says that the kid and the children can't be a part of that process physically. They have to be taken out and put in one of these 36 facilities. In this sense, our laws are not making any sense. In order to change those laws, don't encourage Trump to do it all with his executive pen. The very
we
same
didn't,
people
we
who...
Didn't, cr- we didn't, just again, Matt, this happened, this most recent problem that exists with some 2,000 children being separated from their parents happened because a choice the administration...
On zero tolerance,
made,
you're right.
On zero, they chose that. They just did. It, you know, for the first 18 months of the administration or whatever, they weren't doing it. Then they chose to do it. Then those children became separated. Does Congress need to pass laws? Absolutely.
They sure
do. Congress hasn't done anything on immigration for a long time. It's on both parties to do that. But this current crisis that exists right now with these 2,000 children, it's on this White House and it's on this administration to get those kids reconnected with their families.
I agree.
If they care about that.
I agree with that. I also think that we have to keep, I agree with many of the comments David Gregory made in the previous segment, which is we also have to understand that these people are coming here illegally. And I think the one thing we have to understand, there are people that are seeking political asylum and have the right case. They have the facts on their side. And what we, the message we have to send as a country is don't rush the border and cross illegally, because then you go through the prosecution system, go to a port of entry, go to an embassy. Look at Mexico. They can go right to an embassy in Mexico. They can go through the process quickly and apply to be a political asylee. Don't rush the border. When you rush the border, you're risking the fact that your kids could be separated from you. You're risking the fact that you could be put into a facility and be prosecuted. Do it the right way.
Matt, just to be clear, what you're suggesting is that this policy the administration decided on was a deterrent, which is something they hadn't admitted, but it very well may be. Be that as it may, I wanted to ask you one other thing, because you are, you know, you're a political expert, you know communications very well. Melania Trump, the first lady, went down to the border yesterday to visit firsthand. Good for her. You know, she's the senior most person connected to this administration to go get a look. She asked tough questions. When was the last time you had a chance to talk to someone in your family? But you know communications and you know politics. We saw her jacket, which she chose to wear. She chose to get on the plane in Washington. I really don't care. Do you? Does that send a helpful message for this administration?
You know, John, I think I'm the I might know a lot about politics, but I'm the last person to talk to about women's fashion. I will say this. All I saw when I was busy during the day, as you were yesterday, I saw the video and the images of her meeting with the officials, talking about the kids.
But does this jacket muddy that? Does this jacket muddy that message? That message was clear, was crystal clear. That jacket, and it's not really as much of a fashion commentary as it is a political message. You don't just accidentally wear a jacket that says, I really don't care.
Okay, it's a fair question, John, but this is exactly what frustrates a lot of people in the country. The important thing is that the First Lady went down to the border and met with the officials and talked about the fact, and she was very aggressive on this early, that she didn't believe families should be separated, and we're talking about her coat. And I just think that is what frustrates people. We have a serious issue at hand here. I understand that people are trying to read into this. I don't care what coat she wore.
Oh, you should wear a coat that says, I don't care what coat you wore. I will only say that we can walk and chew gum at the same time. We covered her trip down there. We have talked about the question she asked.
I don't care about her shoes. I don't care about her coat. I care about the fact that she said, I don't want to separate families, and I agree with her on that.
Well, she was sending some kind of message. It would be interesting to know exactly what she meant. But as we've been saying all morning, Matt, good for her to go down there, and good for you to come on and talk to us this morning, as always.
Thank you, John.
Matt Schlapp, thanks for being with us. Allison?
Okay, John.
The revolution will be live.